Hello guys, so welcome to That Time of the Month, and I'm actually really excited to do empty videos. I don't know about you guys, but I actually find just pure satisfaction on finishing a product. I don't know if you guys have this problem where I'm like towards the end of finishing a product and I'm almost like obsessed with trying to finish it, that I overuse it sometimes. Anyways, I'm very excited because this month there's actually quite a few products, and I feel like next month will be a big month as well. But anyways, instead of getting ahead of myself, let's go straight into what I finished this month. Finally, and this has been like for the first time in a long time that I actually finished an eye makeup remover. So this is the Bourjois Paris Maxi Comfort Demaculant. Basically, this one removes waterproof mascara, eyeliners, and so forth. This was super big, so that's probably one that it's taken me a while to finish. First of all, it is definitely great value. It's you get a lot of product for, you know, what you're paying for. However, in terms of removing power, it's not as great as, say, something like L'Oreal. This is sort of more like, on a scale to 1 to 10, the removing power is about 5 to 6, as opposed to, say, L'Oreal is about an 8, Chanel is about a 9, the NARS is about an 8.5. You know, you kind of get what I'm trying to say here. But I mean, obviously value, yes. The one thing I don't really like about it is the packaging, and you know, guys know me already that I don't like these flimsy caps. Next thing I finished is this cleanser, and this is from the Dermicare Clarifying Cleanser Foam. I actually got this as a gift from my good friend in Taiwan, and she told me that this is actually a Taiwanese brand. So I'm not quite sure where you can actually purchase this, but I actually really, really, really enjoy this cleanser. It's like a clay formula, and it actually lathers up really, really well, and it gives you that really clean feel without feeling like it's stripped away a lot of oils. It doesn't feel dry, it doesn't feel oily. The downside to this is obviously the packaging, is because it is a squeeze tube, so towards the end it got really annoying to try to squeeze the rest of the product out, and then a lot of times I had to, like, you know, shake it and then squeeze more out. So towards the end it was just very unpleasant, to the fact that I think I've actually deformed the packaging a little bit just because I was trying to get everything out of it. The next thing I finished is the Mila Diopez Skin Clear Purifying Serum, and actually, I used this one a long time ago when I was pretty much the beginning of my crazy cystic acne breakout, and this was one of the products that I used in conjunction with the, I think it was a purifying toner, which I still have a lot of because it's like a huge bottle, and this is more like a serum. So I kind of use this as a serum, like slash moisturizer in one. So pretty much after I cleanse my face, I use the toner and then I use the serum. The immediate effect I had on my skin when I use this one is that it definitely made my skin feel tighter. It definitely reduced the inflammation and the redness of the cystic acne. However, in terms of clearing it, it wasn't so obvious in that kind of, you know, respect, but it did definitely help to, I guess, reduce the appearance of it. It is a very small 30 ml, but surprisingly a ton of product in there, so it did last quite a while. The next thing I finished is the Origins Modern Friction Gommage Dermo Abrasion. Okay, I'm not gonna try speaking French, but pretty much it's the Nature's Gentle Dermabrasion. I think it's always taken me almost a year to finish this because, one, I'm not too fond of the smell, and two, I'm not too fond of the texture. It actually feels a little bit rich for me. Like, I feel like I'm actually applying a layer of this cream that it's kind of not really doing what I want it to do. I'm pretty sure it does do a great job in actually removing the dead skin cells, but just for me, I'm so particular with my skincare that I feel like, you know, there are, you know, other ones out there that might have a better smell, a better scent, and a better sort of feel, texture in terms. But in terms of price and value, you may get a lot of product in this one. Like I said, I've used this for like almost a year, and I exfoliate at least once a week. Bath and Body Works French Lavender and Honey in the Body Lotion. This one, I'm not a big, huge fan of, only because I feel like I can get a drugstore type that is similar to the scent, and it kind of didn't really, it didn't really blow me away. Like, to be honest with you, I think out of the Bath and Body Works, the whole range, I would probably only repurchase the Cherry Blossom just because it's my favorite. This is the June Jacobs Spa Collection in the Citrus Shower Gel. This came in one of the hotels that I stayed in, like, I think when I was traveling to LA. They were giving these like large size bottles, I don't know why, but anyways, I really, really, really like this. Surprisingly, the citrus scent almost reminds me of like Coca-Cola, and it's like a really unique, it's like a sweet and citrusy flavor. So when I was actually showering and when, you know, the hot water, you know, hits your body, it actually sends off this sort of Coca-Cola aroma, which is really weird. And for some reason, I don't mind that smell of cola. Obviously, I can't actually buy this in the shop, so I'm really sad that I finished it, but it's actually surprisingly good. It's really hydrating. It doesn't, you know, make me feel like, you know, itchy or flaky, and I love the scent. Now, moving on to hair. So I finished the Garnier Fructis Color Last Revives Color Conditioner. To be honest with you, because it is, you know, a drugstore, or I should say a supermarket type of brand and product, that you're not gonna have such high expectations for it to hold color or things like that. I definitely do feel that my hair is softer and it feels a lot more smoother after using it, but it's probably just like the same as every other conditioner out there. This is the Clear Tone Collagen Essence Mask. Basically, it's just like a sheet mask that you use. It comes in like a box like this, and basically you peel the top off and then you just take it out like as if you would take a, you know, a tissue, and then you would just place the facial mask all over your face and you leave it on for about 15 minutes and then you just take it off. It's pretty much like a skincare booster. It's collagen mask. So pretty much what it is, it helps with brightening, it helps with the elasticity of the skin. It kind of just gives your skin that sort of boost of like, you know, goodness, like nutrients. And so if you're really tired, if you're being really stressed at work or school, and if you're being using a ton of products, like, you know, makeup wise, and you just want to give your skin that bit of, you know, nutrients, then this is something to go for. And it's easy, it's affordable, and you get like a bunch of masks in the one pack, so that will last you like a good month or so. I finished a Lift Lumiere Smoothing and Rejuvenating Eye Contour Concealer in number 10. So this one is, I believe this has been discontinued, so I've actually had this for a while. Basically, it's in the Lift Lumiere range by Chanel, which helps with lifting and firming, and this is a concealer, so I only use this around the eye area, but I definitely like the texture of it because it is quite thick, so it gives you a lot of coverage. It is quite moisturizing for the eye area as well. Because it is quite thick and the coverage is quite high, I like to pat a bit more powder on top just to make sure it doesn't move or shift, especially during hot and humid days. So I use that one, like half a pump, sometimes one pump, and then I use that directly onto the eyes. Another concealer that I finished this month is the Tom Ford Concealing Pen, and this one is got the sponge top, and pretty much this is what I would call the high-end version of the Maybelline Age Rewind concealers, which is pretty much does the same thing. It helps to conceal, it helps to highlight, and then it comes in the sponge applicator, which means it's easy to like apply, and then you can just either, you know, blend it in with your fingers or with a sponge. So in terms of color and texture, it's amazing. Like, it's almost better, if not, it's almost the same, if not better than the Maybelline. And also I like the fact that the texture is not too thick, but if you want more coverage, you can build it up and actually apply a bit more. I also finished another Anastasia Brow Wiz, but this time it's in the color Caramel. The reason why I tried Caramel is because I watched Holly Ennery, and she apparently swears by the color Caramel. She's been going through these like one a month, and so I decided to give Caramel a try. I feel like it's quite versatile in terms of, you know, what kind of hair color that you have. So whether you have, you know, dyed hair or you don't, it actually does, you can actually pull it off. This is just one of the colors that I wanted to review as opposed to the product, because I've reviewed this before and I do really, really like it. I also finished the Dolly Wink eyelash glue. Usually glue that comes with the actual lashes are not that great. I think because my expectations for it was so low that it kind of blew me away. It's great for sensitive eyes. It is super adhesive. It lasts all day pretty much, but obviously in comparison to the FX glue that I use previously, that has a lot more waterproof resistance, and whereas this one can kind of come off. If you want a glue that, you know, overall just sticks on lashes and you don't have to worry about it, this is definitely something worth trying. And you get quite a lot of product in this little, you know, jar, because I've had this for a very long time. And I think the packaging is quite cute. It's purple, it's got polka dots, and it's very girly. And I don't know whether this I've mentioned before, but I've used another Next Care Acne, Care Acne Cover. And this one is got the ones with the all the little dots, so 30 stickers. And I feel like the Next Care one, this one in particular, is a lot more thinner than the acne ones that you've been using in the past. In terms of the effectiveness, I feel like it's quite comparable. It's not a huge difference, but I really don't mind the thinness of it because I feel like when a sticker is too thick, it can look a bit bulky, whereas this is quite natural on the face. So sometimes I wake up, I'm like, where did I put the sticker again? I couldn't even notice. So I do quite like these ones. That's all the empties for this month. I know there was quite a lot. If you have any questions about any of these products, leave your comments below. I'll also try to link them as much as I can because I know a lot of these products, sometimes you can't get them online. Some of them were just random. So I will try my best. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Hope you had a lovely month and I will see you in my next video. Bye.